Good morning, students. I hope you all are fine, and I'm pretty sure that you have revised previous lecture. Let's continue our chapter Fiber to Fabric. Rearing of sheep. As all of you know that India is an agricultural country where domestication of cattle plays an important role in the life of farmers, and it affects the economy of the country. For obtaining wool, sheep are reared, their hair is cut and processed into wool. Rearing of sheep involves proper planning for its shelter and taking care of its basic hygiene. It also involves providing sheep proper nutrition and preventing diseases. Sheep is reared in Jammu Kashmir, Himachal Pradesh, Uttaranchal, Arunachal Pradesh, Sikkim, or plains of Haryana, Punjab, Rajasthan, and Gujarat. Feeding management of sheep, that is food for sheep. Sheep are herbivores and prefer grass and leaves. Apart from grazing sheep, rearers also feed them on a mixture of pulses, corn, jowar, oil cakes, and minerals. In winter, sheep are kept indoors and fed on leaves, grains, and dry fodder. Extraction of wool. It means how fleece is changed into wool. It is a series of processes which involves the following steps. Number one, shearing. Number two, scouring. Number three, drying. Number four, sorting. Number five, carding and combing. Number six, spinning. Number seven, dyeing. There are two more processes, that is knitting and weaving, which are used to change this wool into fabric. Let's discuss first step, shearing. It is a process of removing the fleece of the sheep along with the thin layer of its skin. It is done manually with a large razor or with shearing machine. Hair of sheep protect it from extreme cold, so act as a protective coat. Shearing is conducted generally in hot weather so that sheep does not feel cold and can survive easily without its protective coat. Shearing is done annually. The shearing process does not hurt the sheep because the upper part of the skin is normally dead skin. Second step is scouring. It is a process of removing dirt, grease, and dust from the sheared skin along with the fleece of sheep. It can be done manually as well as with the help of machines. Some chemicals as well as detergents are also used in this process. Next step is drying. Cleaning of removed hair of sheep is done with the help of water, as we have discussed earlier. So hair get wet. After scouring, wet hair are then dried in the sun by keeping them on the sheets or on drying rocks. Next is sorting. This process involves the grouping of the wool according to its texture. Sorting is done by the sorters manually. Quality of the wool is decided according to the length, texture, color, scale structure, and fineness. Thus, grading of wool is done according to its quality. Next step is carding and combing. During this process, fibers are passed through rollers, which makes fibers smooth and straight and changes the fibers into a flat sheet called web. In this process, long fibers are separated from the shorter ones and tangles are removed. Impurities are also removed, like vegetation. For example, small twigs, small crushed pieces of dry leaves. Next is spinning. Fibers are stretched and twisted to make them strong and change into yarn. These yarns are wound onto bobbins. Next is dyeing, means coloring. In this step, the fibers are dyed in different colors according to the dictates of fashion and demand. Dyeing can be done at two different stages during extraction of wool. If dyeing is done after scouring, that is just after cleaning it, then it is called as dyed wool. If dyeing is done after it is spun or after the spinning stage, then it is called as yarn dyed. These yarns are wound to form balls of the wool, which is used for knitting or weaving the woolen clothes. Knitting and weaving. We have discussed the series of steps involved in the wool extraction. Now wool is ready and this wool can be changed into fabric by two processes called knitting or weaving. We get sweaters after knitting. Maybe you have seen your mother or grandmother knitting sweaters on two needles for you. We get woolen clothes, carpets after weaving. Now let's discuss some characteristics of wool. Wool does not wrinkle easily. It can trap a lot of air which not allow heat to escape. So keep our body warm during winters. It can absorb moisture up to 1/3 of its weight without losing its property. If we will burn wool, it will give us the smell of burning hair. It has good elasticity and resiliency. Occupational hazards or health problems of the workers. The risks of illness, problems or accidents faced by the worker in an industry are called occupational hazards. Some occupational hazards in the wool industries are: sorters get infected by bacterium called anthrax, which can cause a fatal blood disease called sorter's disease. Sorters can suffer from respiratory diseases like asthma because they inhale small hair while sorting. Sometimes they also suffer from skin, lungs or intestinal infections also. Thank you, students. In the next lecture, I will continue the rest of the chapter. Till then, keep revising.